please rise for the playing of our national anthem by the sixth grade band. Thank you very much. Welcome you to this evening's afternoon's performance here. And first up on our program, Alien Invasion, which you'll hear a little bit about from our guest conductor. Our guest conductor this afternoon will be Miss Elizabeth Carvel, who is a senior here. She is doing an internship with me. Every morning she comes over to spend first period with us. So she does some of the lessons and then also some of the band rehearsal with our students. She wants to go into music education, so I thought let's feed her to the sharks and see how she does and see if we can change her mind at all through this process. But it has been great to watch her grow and learn as she's figured out and is figuring out how to become a band director. So let's welcome Miss Elizabeth Carvel to the stage.
What a role model. I'm sorry. So as Mr. Roach said, I've been... What? Oh yeah, Mr. Roach did Yinger. Yeah, he's an excellent role model too.
He chose me, not you.
Definitely. Oh boy. Anyway, I've had the pleasure of working and teaching and conducting both bands, but especially I really love working with the sixth graders. The piece that they'll be playing is called Alien Invasion, and it features our wonderful trombone section. They have a musical term called a glissando throughout the piece, and it's very fun, and I hope you all enjoyed it. Thank you.
Thank you.
This next song features the gong. I'll give them a minute to figure out where they're putting everything. The life of a percussionist. 1 minute you might play the triangle, the next minute you might play the timpani, the next minute you might have to run across the whole entire band and hit something on the bells. And they all do a wonderful job of it. And really, in sixth grade, it's kind of the first time they get to experience a lot of shifting like that. And it can be quite chaotic at times. Next up, actually, our next piece has a little bit of audience participation. So you're going to be able to participate in this one. I need everyone to hold their hands up like this. All right, great. And with your best snapping ability, let me hear a couple snaps. Great. Now, the next thing you need to know is you need to know when to do that, okay? So if I turn around and I do something like this, what do you think you do? And then if you see me do this, what do you think you do? Okay, so let's practice real quick. Ready? That's pretty good. Hey, I think we just recruited like 500 more people for our band. All right, awesome. We'll start on Monday. So you do have those two roles, Falling Rain. You're going to help us out with the rain portion, as well as our brand new rain stick. Liam, can you feature the rain stick for us for a second? No, can you actually make it rain? He's been waiting his whole life to do that, by the way. I asked him, I said, what you play is your favorite out of everything you play in the percussion section? He goes, the rain stick. And I'm like, great. We'll be in good shape. Here we are, Falling Rain. pretty good for your first concert. I'll give you a solid A- on that one, all right? That was nice. One of the greatest composers of all time is John Williams. He's written many movie scores and won many Grammys. And I was telling the students that, you know, he's a great composer and everything. And I said, he won a lot of Grammys. I don't know the total amount. And then they came to me today, this is how invested your students are, to tell me that he won 87 Grammys. So they took the time to like look it up and actually follow this guy. And now they're all probably Facebook friends, for all I know. But it's pretty cool that they went home and, you know, did the research to find out exactly like a little bit about this composer. We all know Indiana Jones. We all know the Raiders March. We hope that we sound like it. Thank you very much for the sixth grade portion of the concert. And then as soon as they're finished, there will be another little twist in the program. And I'll cover that a little bit later. You can leave that open, because we're going to do something in a little bit. All right. Whoa, what's happening over here? Just the drummers. Everybody else, just hang tight. They're so excited to play, and I love that. Okay. All right. This is the moment where parents, if you want to, grab your phones and take a picture. We're going to bring the rows up one at a time. A couple years ago, we had a parent say, hey, I can't see my granddaughter, my daughter in the back row playing the trumpet, because she's short. And she said, can you, have them stand one row at a time? And I wrote back and I said, that's a great idea. Why didn't I think of that? So here we are, percussion. Let's recognize them. All right. All right, then our back row holding down the brass, trumpets, trombones, French horns, baritone, and the tuba. Okay, in the middle row, we're going to feature our saxophones and part of our clarinets, including the bass clarinet. Okay, and I think that's everybody, so. Oh, wait. I'm like, you're in the front. You don't need to stand. All right, let's hear it. Flutes and clarinets, come on up. The sixth grade band. All right, you guys are heading off that way. Okay, remember, putting your instruments away. You're waiting back there until we're done the buckets, got it? Next up, something that's not on the program. And I don't know, whoever made it forgot it. And that's because we're gonna feature our percussion. In the 7th and 8th grade piece, the band music that they have very minimal music for this concert. I don't know who programmed it, but I thought, you know, I want to give them something special for them to do. You know, they put in a lot of hard time and a lot of hard work, especially during the marching season. It's pretty gruesome. The first time they're ever looking at a set of marching bass drums and marching snare drums and quints and trying to figure out which drum to hit and when and how and then actually go down the street and do it together. It's chaos if you can't believe it. But they do such a great job, and I really love this particular group because not only are they great percussions, hey, listen, I'm trying to give you a compliment. You all can get ready too, by the way. Come on, I'm stalling so you can be ready. Not only are they great percussionists, they are one of the most humble and, I can't even be serious. They're really good children, okay? In rehearsal, they're not back there having sword fights with their drumsticks. They're paying attention, and it's a really good group. So I'm like, we're gonna feature you here. The piece is called Plastic Surgery, and you're gonna see a little bit of Home Depot versus Lowe's, I guess. We have all Home Depot buckets, and then Andrew, say hi, Andrew. Andrew said, hey, my dad works for Lowe's. Do you think we could get Lowe's buckets? And I said, do you think we could get Lowe's buckets? And he's like, I think I'll ask. And I'm like, beautiful. So he showed up with them today, so they're fresh. All right. And let's hear it for Plastic Surgery. Luca, you were supposed to get a chair and stand for me. Did we talk about that? Okay, that's all right.
Race car team, right?
I gotta get sticks.
Thank you.
come on out. This will be a little unorganized, okay? We don't ever get to practice both groups together. All right, so up for first raffle, we have a lady's glasses with a purple plate case with clear frames and black temples. They'll be up here on the front of the stage if they're yours. Oh, let me get that tube out of the way. Yeah, I'm gonna get that out of the way. All right, I'm going to bring Miss Carvel back out to introduce this next piece.
Hello again, I'm back. Before we play this next piece, I'd really like to take a moment to thank Mr. Roach, because he's been absolutely amazing letting me teach and conduct and teaching me how to teach this past semester, and he's not rid of me yet. I'm here for another semester with him. You cannot escape me. So, you know, this has been really fun. the next piece is called Episode for Band. It's sort of a classic band piece, especially for middle school. It highlights a lot of different sections with different melodies and counter melodies. So, yes, I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you.
I tell you what, we keep turning out music educators. I might be out of a job. But doesn't she do a wonderful job? She's not here right now, but hey. We were talking, probably every time she conducts, we chat a little bit about the good, the bad, and the ugly. And I said, it's pretty cool that, you know, you even get this experience, because I didn't have this experience when I was in school. To know if I, you know, I knew I wanted to go into music ed, but I don't know, I never directed in front of a group before. So I think this is really cool. You're going to see a lot of purple people coming out here. We are going to do a piece that has been 4 years in the making. And you might go, okay, well, if it's been 4 years, it should sound pretty good then by now, right? Well, this was supposed to happen May 5th, 2020. And I probably don't need to really tell you what happened during those months of 2020. And we need to probably get some extra chairs and stuff. Some of them I haven't even seen since then. They got a lot taller. And these seniors, we're going to do this piece that we're going to play for you at that concert and feature one of our eighth graders on the trumpet. And as the years went by, I just had this in the back of my head that someday we're going to do this again, or get to do this. So it's senior year, and I said, hey, would you all like to come back and play with us? And it was like a resounding yes. I don't think anybody said no, so that's good. I mean, they have to be at this concert anyway. So we are going to feature Lizzie Carvel. I'm going to get your stand for you. On Trumpeter's Lullaby by Leroy Anderson. He's the same dude that wrote Sleigh Ride. You know the song? The slapstick? Yeah, he wrote that. And he wrote this trumpet feature called Trumpeter's Lullaby. Only one sheet. And our seniors are going to join us and Lizzie as we play this. Come on out, Lizzie. Woo!
Thank you. Yes.
You don't know how full my heart is right now. Wasn't that wonderful? So beautiful. Nicely done. I always tell the students the pretty music's the hardest music to teach them to play, because everybody can play loud, obnoxious, and fast, but being able to be refined and mature and build that skill set of community and playing like a team together, that's the hard stuff. And I'm really proud of the efforts that they made for that piece. And also in the sixth grade on the Falling Rain piece. It was falling a couple weeks ago, but it was not rain. And I'm telling you what, they have a great way of putting everything together in the ninth hour and giving me an extra gray hair. But it's just my delight to be able to work with them. That's probably my son back there, Judah. Hi, Judah. His daddy. I'll be quiet now so we can get this last piece done. Journey, some medley from Journey, a bunch of songs in it. You'll probably recognize them. Here it is. Oh, I wanted to thank you all for coming out today. So thank you. Thank you, students. Without you, I wouldn't have a job. Thank you for investing music education in your student. We talk all the time about them taking this with them beyond school, beyond high school. You can play your instrument. You might not be an athlete forever. There's a point where your body's probably not going to be able to take the beating. And I'm not trying to downplay athletics at all whatsoever. But you giving them this skill is something that they're going to be able to take with them forever. And I love getting to gigs and seeing like the 80-year-old trombone player getting his trombone out. It's usually Dave's dad, but getting his trombone out and, you know, putting it together to play. And it's so awesome to be able to play alongside somebody like that who's had all that experience. And see that. So here we are, a little bit of Journey to round our portion out before the high schoolers.
Hi, Harper.
Thank you.
I'd like to recognize two soloists, and then we'll do the whole stand thing again, and then we'll be done, I promise. Okay, so soloist trumpet, Carter Zandvoort. Alto saxophone, Madison McCartney. Both seventh graders, so I think our music department's in fine shape for the next however many years, because I can't do math. All right, here we are, the back row, percussion, where are you? Here, Will, stand there. You too, Scotty. Back row, brass, low people, tubas. Next row, clarinet, saxophone, flutes in the back. No, not you yet. Front row, come on up.
Thank you.
You don't know what a journey that was for him, too, let me tell you. What was on the slideshow at the beginning, he would literally, like, look in the door, we'd play a note, and he'd... for, like, a good 6 months. Good job, Evan. Good job, man. Our first piece, you may have noticed in the program, the composer has a bit of an odd name. You might know the well-known band, you know, music composers, Mozart, Beethoven, those guys, and Pink Zebra is right in that same echelon. But it's actually a pseudonym, surprise there. And no one really, I'm sure a few people know who it is, but I think it's kind of like part of the publicity stunt thing with social media and everything, that whoever it is has purposely not revealed his, I believe it is, we have figured out, is a male composer, but it's apparently someone who's very well known in the composing, especially in choral works and film scoring. They've been nominated for Grammys and stuff, but it's still kind of a secret as to who it is. But whoever they are, they write some really nice music. So we hope you guys enjoy Fanfare for a New Era. Next one, the Ludlows. You may recall a movie from, at least when I was growing up, called Legends of the Fall. Remember that one? Ladies, you had that Brad Pitt poster hanging in your room, didn't you? You know you did. Young Brad Pitt, you know? but I recall that music from that movie, even when I was growing up watching it, and I found this arrangement of it. It's just beautiful. It features Elie Fasig on the piano over there, as well as several other soloists throughout. It's a beautiful piece of music. We hope you enjoyed the Ludlows.
Bye.
mention somebody that you might not think of as a soloist, but pretty much everything that our percussion section plays is a solo in and of itself. And you might not think of, I think there's about 11 or 12 triangle hits in that tune, but every one of them is important. And my good buddy Thomas Sees back there, playing the triangle, there's a lot more to it than you think. There's actually technique. It's not just bang the triangle. And Thomas does a really nice job. Thomas, give him a wave. Good job back there, everyone. Final selection today, before we play, I just want to mention that we do have a lot of cookies and chips and pretzels and drinks down in the cafeteria. So please join us for some refreshments afterwards, as well as that'll be a good place to meet up with your kids, whether they're in middle school or in high school. Get some pictures, and high school students, I know that parents like getting a picture of you in your uniform, not just in your shorts and t-shirt, so you may want to just leave them on for, I know they're really comfortable. They're way better than the ones we had when I was a student, at least. But please join us in the cafeteria. We got plenty of food and snacks down there as well. Our final selection is by a composer who goes by his actual name, Claude T. Smith. He's not a colorful creature from Africa or anything like that. He's Claude T. Smith. He's one of the more well-known band composers of the last probably 100 years. This is called Sonus Ventorum. A hallmark of Claude T. Smith's music is he always puts in some little like random time signature things where it's like not just in 4/4. He puts like a 5/8 bar, a 7/4, 7/8, and this one does not disappoint there. Has several different kind of sections in it, but it still has the main themes of the piece coming through. So hope you guys enjoy it. And thank you all for being here. I know you have to take your kids home, so you didn't really have a choice. But thank you for supporting what we do here in the music department in South Middleton and involving your kids in music. I know that Mr. Roach and I both believe it's a very important thing for children to be exposed to and be involved in. So they're in a good place. We got a lot of nice things happening here. We're really proud of it. So thank you very much.